William's wife has revealed the last thing he said to her, and it's absolutely heartbreaking. Robin Williams' suicide in August of 2014 sent shockwaves through the entertainment industry and stunned the millions of fans he had charmed for more than four decades. But, of course, as well as the public trauma, the tragedy had a personal impact as well, and it was one that really hit home. A year after the awful event, Williams' wife, Susan Schneider, opened up about the last thing the comic actor ever said to her, and as you may expect, it's desperately sad. Robin McLaurin Williams was born in Chicago on July 21, 1951, to an automobile industry executive father and a mother who was a former model. After his school days, Williams studied at the prestigious Juilliard School Performing Arts Conservatory in New York. But then he switched his focus from acting to stand-up comedy. He moved to the West Coast, where he became a regular on the San Francisco comedy circuit, and in 1977, he made his TV debut on NBC's Laugh-In. Just a year later, the comedian landed the role that launched him to international fame, playing the eponymous alien in the sitcom Mork and Mindy. Despite an early setback on the big screen in the title role of the 1980 flop Popeye, Williams also went on to forge an impressive film career. He received Oscar nominations for his star performance in 1989's Dead Poets Society, and 2 years later for The Fisher King. In 1998, the funny man dropped the comedy and won Best Supporting Actor at the Academy Awards for his dramatic turn in Good Will Hunting. The Hollywood hits just kept coming for Williams, and he remained a hot property for both comic and serious roles. Good Morning Vietnam, Awakenings, and One Hour Photo were just some of the big movies that kept Williams on the A-list throughout his career. He became a family favorite too, thanks to memorable roles in Mrs. Doubtfire, Jumanji, Hook, and the Night at the Museum series. He also stole the show as the voice of the genie in 1992's Disney animation, Aladdin. Williams spent the first decade of his Hollywood career married to the dancer Valerie Velarde. The pair, who welcomed son Zach into the world in 1983, sadly divorced in 1988 after 10 years of marriage. Controversially, the union broke down because of Williams' affair with Zach's nanny, Marcia Garces. But this new relationship proved to be an enduring one, and the couple walked down the aisle in 1989. Williams and Garces had two children together, Zelda Ray in the year they were married, and Cody Allen 2 years later, before splitting in 2008. Now 57 years old, the A-lister met his third wife, Susan Schneider, shortly before undergoing heart surgery in early 2009. The 45-year-old graphic designer helped nurse the star back to health, and 2 years later, the pair wed at a star-studded ceremony. Alongside celebrity names such as George Lucas, Steven Spielberg, and Billy Crystal, Williams' three children also attended the nuptials in California's Napa Valley. But like so many successful comedians who appear to be all smiles on the surface, Williams found himself battling several demons down the years. As a stand-up notorious for his manic energy, he developed a serious addiction to cocaine during his rise to fame. Subsequently, the actor entered rehab for alcohol abuse in 2006, and then again in 2014. In addition to these drug and alcohol issues, Williams regularly suffered from severe bouts of depression. Shortly before his death, the star was wrongly diagnosed with Parkinson's disease. In fact, Williams was suffering from another condition which shares some of the characteristics of Parkinson's and Alzheimer's. Lewy body disease was later believed to be a contributory factor in the star's decision to take his own life. Symptoms of the dementia illness include constant fear and anxiety, insomnia, stress, memory loss, and tremors. After his death, Schneider said, "Robin was losing his mind and he was aware of it. He kept saying, 'I just want to reboot my brain.'" Sadly, it seems that Williams found himself unable to cope any longer. On August 11, 2014, he hung himself at his California home. An autopsy revealed that no alcohol or illegal drugs were involved in the death, but the report also stated that Williams had experienced a recent increase in paranoia. Schneider later said, "However you look at it, the presence of Lewy body disease took his life." His third wife also led the tributes to the fallen star, describing Williams as a beloved artist and beautiful human being. His daughter Zelda said, "The world is forever a little darker, less colorful, and less full of laughter in his absence." President Barack Obama was moved to say, "He arrived in our lives as an alien, but he ended up touching every element of the human spirit." Apparently, Williams had spent his final 24 hours enjoying a perfect day with his wife. And a little more than a year later, Schneider revealed her husband's final words to her in an interview with TV magazine show Good Morning America. She began, "I was getting in bed and he came in the room a couple times and he said, 'Good night, my love.'" With tears in her eyes, the widow continued, "And then he came back again. He came out with his iPad and he looked like he had something to do." Schneider evidently took this as a positive sign, saying, "And that was like, I think he's getting better. And then he said, 'Good night, good night.' That was the last." Schneider believes that William had spent that final day with his wife, fully aware that he was going to end his own life. She explained to Good Morning America's Amy Robach, "We just did what we love to do together. And I know now he gave me that perfect day, that he gave us that perfect day. He knew what he was doing." In the same week as that interview, in November of 2015, Schneider also appeared on ABC's daytime talk show, The View. She took the opportunity to dismiss press reports that her marriage to Williams had been under strain at the time of his suicide. But Schneider did admit that the star's condition, then still wrongly suspected to be Parkinson's, had made life difficult. She opened up to the show's hosts, Joy Behar and Paula Faris, saying, "You know, we were living a nightmare." Schneider referred to one particular incident shortly before her husband's death. Noticing that Williams was standing by the bathroom sink while she showered, she emerged to find him dabbing his head with a blood-soaked towel. She said, "I just screamed. Robin, what happened? What did you do?" And he pointed to the door, and I said, "Did you hit your head?" And he nodded. Although she was confused by the incident at the time, Schneider now believes Williams' injury was caused by a side effect of Lewy body disease. The condition impairs the sufferer's vision, including spatial awareness and the ability to identify and recognize objects. Schneider told The View, "I don't think he was trying to hit his head on the door. I know that's right." Schneider also went on to reveal that just a week before his death, the star's doctors had decided to arrange an appointment for medical tests. She believes this had a major impact on William's state of mind and ultimately his decision to commit suicide. She explained to Behar and Faris, "I think he was just saying no, and I don't blame him one bit. I don't blame him one bit." Schneider went on to say that Williams had previously never discussed the subject of suicide with her. She recalled, "No, I mean, he was sick and tired of what was going on, absolutely. But the widow maintained that the possibility of him taking his own life was never raised." She added, "When he got the Parkinson's diagnosis, you know, I mean, in one sense, it was like, this is it. But also like, oh my God, what does this mean?" Sadly, Schneider and Williams' three offspring became embroiled in a legal dispute following the star's death. Schneider told Good Morning America that lawyers representing Zach, Zelda, and Cody had arranged for the removal of everything from the marital home. The inventory included items that had been gifted to the couple as wedding presents. This action was a prelude to the legal process of determining who should get what. Schneider was later awarded the property and ongoing monies to maintain it. In September 2016, Schneider penned an essay, "The Terrorist Inside My Husband's Brain," for the specialist title Neurology. It was her bid to raise awareness of Lewy body disease. In the piece, Schneider revealed further information about William's final few months, including his inability to remember lines while working on one of his final films, Night at the Museum 3. The widow concluded her article by thanking all the science and medical professionals who continue to research the merciless condition that contributed to her husband's death. Please share this video with your friends below.